Greetings and best wishes for a happy holiday season from all of us at 2K Sports as we get set for this NBA presentation. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by my colleagues Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And now we take a brief check at the matchups, our starting five for both teams. And guys, what are we going to be looking for in this one from Tim Duncan?
And he is also a tireless worker under the glass, Steve. More than a few guys have been on the receiving end of one of his elbows when a rebound is up for grabs. He uses his body very well.
Looking at San Antonio, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Clippers. And that one a tough loss, too. They ended down only 3 points.
That final score really caught a lot of people off guard. I think we would have to quantify that one as an upset.
Yeah, I thought they really tightened up at the end, guys. I mean, I think they were playing not to lose instead of playing to win. You got to go after wins. You can't try to hold on to them. You got to go get them.
Parker with the steal. Puts the lead pass in front of him. Oh, and the jam by Leonard. It's not possible what we just saw. Is that possible?
Not probable, but it is possible, partner. It is possible.
And think about it, guys. That's one of the few guys in the entire league who can pull off something like that. And one bright note for the Pacers last season was the play of their bench. Adding Rodney Stuckey was a huge boost for them.
Now, here is George. Five on the clock. Right side, George. The finger roll finish at the bucket.
No, he didn't. Did he just break out the finger roll? That's nice.
Indiana on D. And Stuckey led the charge for the Pacers bench, Greg, as you were talking about. But all around, the reserves, Clark, were fantastic on the Pacers.
Yeah, third in the league at almost 41 points per game off the bench. First in the NBA in bench rebounding. And top 10 in field goal percentage as a bench.
Here's George, following the basket by LaMarcus Aldridge. And now, just over a minute played here in the first. George against Leonard. Now, here's George. He's guarded closely, and that one's good. George has got his second bucket. On offense, here are the Spurs. This their first chance this season playing the Pacers.
Yeah, and they swept this matchup the two times they played last year. They held the advantage on paper and on the court.
Yeah, exactly. An interconference matchup here. Not a lot of familiarity, but I wouldn't say they caught them off guard. There's a reason one team was in the playoffs and the other team was watching.
Looking at the last game for the Indiana Pacers, it was a loss to Memphis.
And the issues they had defensively, in part, I thought, was a huge factor. Really compounded, I think, because it was a road game for them.
Well, you know, they gave the crowd a bunch to cheer about. And when you do that, you put yourself in a really tough position trying to come away with a road win.
Now, here is George. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against the Grizzlies in Memphis.
And don't forget his unbelievable steal total in that game. I mean, almost to the point they didn't want to bring the ball up the floor.
Here's Ginobili. Paul George making his last shot. Now here's Ginobili. 11 points for him in that last game against the Clippers. George against Leonard. Lots of room. And the Spurs scoring again.
Lights out here, right out of the gate. Perfect 4-4 from the floor.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
I was able to speak with Frank Vogel for a minute. They'll be facing one of the best post players ever to play the game in Tim Duncan. Coach told me that even though Timmy isn't as physically gifted as he once was, he is still a handful to deal with. He said a lot of people forget this, but Tim Duncan is one of the smartest players to ever play and always makes the right decision. We can't be lazy around him.
All right, Doris. And here is Ginobili. George Hill getting it to go from deep. And he gets it to go.
And they're just raining threes on both ends.
Boy, I love the answer. You come at me with the three, I'm coming right back with my own triple.
And so last season for Tony Parker, somewhat of a shift. I mean, he was solid, but injuries cost him a few games. He also had his lowest assists and points per game totals since his rookie year. But he fought through like the champion that he is.
And Leonard gets it to go.
And they are cooking, on fire right now, really flowing well.
Outside Hill. And George kicks to Allen. The dish to Hill. He passes to Ellis. It's back to Hill. Some nice passing here by Indiana. Ellis goes in. And that one's good.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Ginobili outside. He kicks to Parker. Duncan with a screen on Hill. And that one's good. Parker.
They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Clearly, they've been the aggressors thus far when it comes to attacking the interior in this first half.
Here's George following the score by Tony Parker. Hill passes to George. And Indiana, another three.
That's a layup for him. He's just too open.
San Antonio leading. Parker outside. The feet to Ginobili. Three-pointer. Hill gets the rebound. Pacers have gotten 6 or 7 shots to fall in the first quarter. They're off and running. George dishes to Ellis. Pass to Allen. He feeds it to George. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
The right thing there to stay that tight on him and really try to keep him out of his comfort zone.
Parker kicks to Aldridge. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Here's what San Antonio is going with right now. West comes in for Tim Duncan, and it's Green in for Manu Ginobili. So timeout called here, the first for Indiana.
And guys, remember, LaMarcus Aldridge last January suffering a torn ligament in his thumb, scheduled to undergo surgery and miss 2 months of the season. But he opted to tough it out and keep playing. And boy, how big was that for the Blazers?
Now, here is Hill. His last outing, 16 points for him. No good with the triple.
A clear look at the hoop. He doesn't miss many of those.
Leonard attacking. Pass to West. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. And Aldridge postponing that thumb injury surgery, even though they said it might double his eventual recovery time.
Yeah, I think it's pretty admirable that he was out there, because he wasn't just playing in pain. He was playing hurt. That shows you his commitment to winning.
Here's Ellis after David West's bucket. And George kicks to Ellis. Elbow shot is on the way. And that one's good.
Well, if you like offense, that's what you're getting here early on.
This has a little bit of playground feel to it, fellas. I mean, forget about defending. Just outscore the other team. Let it fly.
Leonard, the pass to Aldridge. And yes, sir, that one drops.
That's his fourth straight make right out the chute. He's setting a pretty high standard for himself here.
Just like you draw it up before you come out.
Now, here's George. He's got 9. Dishes it to Ellis. There's the pick. Back to George. Lets it go from deep, and he gets it to go. George has got 12 points in the game.
They're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results right now.
You're right. 3 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
Here's Parker. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Clippers.
And also, his assist total tells you about the job he did of keeping his head up and keeping his teammates involved. what a passing display he has put on here tonight.
Yeah, he's spoiling this, Greg. I mean, this just another fantastic dime drop right there. That one certainly should make the highlight reel.
Now, here is Hill. Some good scoring numbers for him right now, averaging 17 points a game. Outside, George fires from deep, and the Pacers another three.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Now we get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. Taking a look at Oklahoma City. Quite a season they've assembled here, guys. Perched up there in first place and playing terrific basketball game in and game out. And, of course, the San Antonio Spurs, 6.5 games behind them.
And, you know, right now for San Antonio, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed, and that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Here's Hill following the three-pointer by San Antonio. Hill kicks to Stuckey. Stuckey left side. Turner. .121 left in the first quarter of the game. Well, the Spurs, Greg, great at home last year. That's not surprising to anyone who's paid attention. We expect that. They're just so tough at home year in and year out.
And, Kevin, how about going 33-8 at home last season? And despite being the sixth seed, only the Hawks and Warriors, the two best records in the league, won more games at home. Hard to imagine you could be a sixth seed with that kind of success.
Now, here is Hill. Feeds to Mahimi. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. And now just a one-point San Antonio lead. San Antonio's gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game.
For the Spurs, it was all about being at home. That was a big part of how they went on the run. They won 20 of the last 22 games at home in that stretch, which vaulted them from the bottom of the playoff picture in the West to as high as the two seed.
Three-pointer, Butler. That's good. Butler's got six.
Boy, I tell you what, he loves getting looks like that from the three-point line. No one near him. That's a warm-up jumper for him.
Shot and game clock separated by five. Stuckey kicks to Hill. It's Hill on the wing for the three. No good. He dishes it to West. Ring shot on the way. And so the first quarter is in the books. The offense still waking up here a little bit. Spurs lead by four.
Spend your Christmas day with the NBA. Kawhi Leonard and the San Antonio Spurs hit the road for a duel with the Houston Rockets this Friday, 11 Eastern, 8 Pacific.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Spurs.
Really some great drives to the basket here early on for these guys.
Another thing they've been able to really get going so far tonight has been the three ball, the long-range shooting.
Mills and Manu at the guard. Matt Bonner is out there with Boris Diaw, and it's Butler in at the small forward. So that's who San Antonio starts the second with.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over and over.
And they may have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their ninth straight point from beyond the arc.
Kicks to Whittington. Hill, a screen on Dia. Passes it to Stuckey. That one a little long.
There's no getting around the simple fact that that's a shot he has to knock down.
Diaw sets the pick for Ginobili. Makes it off the glass. And now a 9-point San Antonio lead.
And those are two teammates right there working in rhythm. One setting the screen and the other using it to get that separation.
Stuckey dishes to Budinger. And good coming on the assist by Rodney Stuckey.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Ginobili outside. The pass to Diop. Here's the dish to Mills. He kicks it to Ginobili. This one for three. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
These defenders are putting up very little resistance to the three-point shot.
And it's killing four of the last five makes coming from long range. And guys, every time we think Patty Mills is going to take the next step in his development, he takes a step back. Last season, he shot career lows from the field and behind the arc after having one of his best ever campaigns the year before. That really just makes a coach pull his hair out. And fortunately, me, I don't have it.
The feed now to Bonner. Pass to Diaw. From the arc. Hill pulls it in. Pacers trail by nine. He passes to Budinger. It's back to Hill. He feeds it to Budinger. Stuckey. Pass to Budinger. Deep two from Hill. Drops one in from the wing. Hill's got his first points of the game.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Ginobili the pass to Mills. Outside Butler. Sinks the triple. Butler's got his third basket of the night right there.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
Timeout called the Pacers. Well, the Pacers, despite all their injuries from last season, were right in the playoff hunt until the very end. Had a chance, in fact, GA, on the last day to sneak in, but it didn't happen.
Yeah, they needed a Brooklyn loss to go along with them winning that last game. Ultimately, though, it wasn't in the cards for them, and they ended a game out of the postseason.
Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played. George with a screen on Parker. Ellis kicks to Miles. Back to Ellis. And it's good. Walk through contact, hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
And, you know, the Pacers had made the playoffs in each of the last four seasons prior to last year's miss. Hard for a team that was coming off back-to-back conference finals appearances to stomach that. But with the injuries, they'll be better and back in the playoffs next year, I'm sure.
The Pacers shooting their first foul shot of the night.
And really, it's going to be more of a reload than a rebuild situation for the Pacers. You would have to imagine their goal isn't just to get back to the playoffs, but to get back to being a conference final participant.
A three from Leonard. And again, it's San Antonio with a three.
They just continue to splash home those threes. Eliminating the deep shot has to become priority number one for this defense.
Absolutely. You cannot allow a team to have that kind of a rhythm from beyond.
George with the ball. Picked up by Aldridge. From deep, Ellis. And Allen with the layup.
Where's the box out? Some easy second chance opportunities there.
Those kinds of mistakes drive me crazy and will absolutely derail a team's chance to win.
Duncan dishes to Parker. That's good, and so Duncan with the assist. Parker's got his second basket of the game.
Pretty, pretty passive. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Ellis with it. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Grizzlies in Memphis.
Yeah, but I also thought the rebounding was impressive. He got some huge boards in that game. You have got to make some kind of a defensive adjustment here. He is just lighting them up from beyond.
Greg, I don't know what else they can do. I mean, even when they've closed out on him, he's still been knocking them down.
George against Ginobili. Back to Parker. Six to shoot. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Parker's got 4 points in the quarter.
And that's his strong suit, the ability to find his way through the D and finish at the rim.
Parker against Ellis. Vicious to Buttinger. Indiana needs to get a shot off. George, that's a two-pointer. And there are the Pacers with another bucket.
And he's really shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
Kyle Anderson, he's checked in for Manu Ginobili. Spurs leading by seven. Feeds to Aldridge. Soft touch off the glass. Aldridge has got 11 points.
Really well done there. Just confident and composed, never in a hurry.
George against Aldridge. And George kicks to Miles. And it's tipped. Anderson outside. He dishes it to Parker. Kicks to Aldridge. Stolen by Ellis. A finish. Rips down the breakaway slam.
Also, guys, so often we see him playing possum at the defensive end. And then all of a sudden he springs into action, picks off a pass, and ignites the fast break.
Passes it to Leonard. Outside Aldridge. There's the pass to Anderson. He kicks it to Leonard. Six on the shot clock. Fires it up. And it's San Antonio with another.
You know, for so long, the NBA has had 12-minute quarters. In last year's preseason, they began experimenting with the 10-minute quarters. Players seem to like it, but it would be a huge change philosophically in terms of how the game is played.
Miles, that's good. Spurs leading by six. And for C.J. Miles, he sure can string together a long line of threes under the league with a nice jump shot that has now become deadly.
Yeah, he doesn't get to the free throw line much, but and he's not really much of a playmaker, but he's 3D in color. HD 3D.
And again, it's Kawhi Leonard. Leonard's got seven now in this quarter.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
The dish to Buttinger. Indiana moving the ball around. That's good for Miles on the assist from Buttinger. Miles has got 6 points.
And talking about C.J. Miles, he was filthy last year. Indiana needed his spark offensively, especially without Paul George in the lineup. Miles responded by putting up career highs in points and minutes played. Just an unbelievable impact on the season.
Leonard against Buttinger. Ellis right side. Pass to Miles. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
And for most every team out there, guys, they're looking for a guy like C.J. Miles. Decent size, natural movement skills, and can absolutely shoot the lights out. Call him Buckets, because that's a lethal formula.
Parker against Buttinger. And that one's good. Parker. And now it's a 10-point Spurs lead.
And that's what you like to see from a competitor. Really able to just shake off that poor first quarter and focus on the here and now.
Aldridge against George. Back to Allen. The shot's good on the assist by George. George has got his third assist on the night.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
The feed to Leonard. Duncan with a screen for Leonard. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful. Leonard's got 12 now in this quarter.
Well, I tell you what, when you get this kind of effort and efficiency from him, they're a really hard team to beat.
And George kicks to Ellis. He feeds it to Miles. 40 seconds left now here in the second. Miles with another miss.
And even though he missed that, you have to take those shots when you get the opportunity.
Exactly. They don't come much better or easier than that.
Parker passes to Alden. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
That was the third straight high percentage look this defense has allowed. I mean, these defenders have got to start bumping bodies in the paint. Be more physical. Be more aggressive.
The game's just far too easy right now when it comes to attacking the basket. They have got to do better.
David West, he's checked in for San Antonio. Green comes in for Kyle Anderson. 2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. And George gets it to go. George has got 22.
And his stroke has been dead on from the outside. I mean, inside, outside. It just doesn't matter.
It's Parker with the drive. Pulls up on the elbow. That'll do it for the first half. It's the Spurs up by 11. Well, it's been a one-sided affair so far through the first two quarters, but there's plenty of time to mount a comeback. You look at Paul George in this game, guys, he's been everywhere.
You just love it when the decision-making is as good as it was there in that first half. Didn't force anything.
Guys, I think here in the second half, though, they may want him to be a little more assertive. Start hunting more for his shot. Even the tough...
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. On the court for Indiana. They've got Paul George, LaVoy Allen out there with Hill, and it's George Hill, and it's Ellis, and at the shooting guard. Spurs leading by 11.
There are certain things, guys, that you can always count on in life. Death, taxes, and of course the Spurs winning 50 games in the regular season. Happened for the 16th straight season last year.
And Indiana shooting has been just uncontainable. 72%. Hill dishes to George. It's back to Hill. That is good. Hill's got his second basket of the night.
And I'll bet his percentage is pretty high from that range.
Parker kicks to Alden. Pass to Leonard. Lock at six. Pacers with the rebound. Ellis outside. He passes to Hill. And Parker comes with the help. Hill kicks to George. From deep. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Hill's got three assists tonight.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding, and they're piling up the assists. That's three of four here to start the half.
Timeout call, the Pacers.
And how good a playmaker has Tony Parker been? One of the best in recent history. The all-time leader in assists for the Spurs over his 14 years there. Just a crafty guy with the ball in his hand.
And our 2K leaderboard up on the screen now, giving you a look at the small forward position and the players with the most rebounds per game this year. Kawhi Leonard on top in the third spot, Paul George.
You know, the work they do on the boards is such a big part of all these players' game. I mean, they play much bigger than the grand majority of small forwards in our league.
Yeah, I think they all have that little bit of extra edge to their game that allows them to put up the kind of rebound numbers usually you only see from power forwards.
And continuing our talk of Tony Parker, the first year he laced up his sneakers, He increased the tempo for that entire Spurs offense, and it continues to this day.
Yeah, and the increase in floor spacing and tempo, a big reason the Admiral, Tim Duncan, and Parker won the championship together in 2003, and obviously Duncan and Parker have won a few more rings since then.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. Everyone knows about the Paul George injury from last year and how it affected the Pacers. He sat almost the entire season, and there was no doubt they missed him.
Yeah, and when George came back, Kevin, the Pacers got hot, but they had to put him on a minute's limit. And it wasn't just George, though. The team as a whole had a lot of injuries during the course of the season.
Ellis against Ginobili. Back to Leonard. Out to Parker. There's the three. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. 11 points for Tony Parker.
And, you know, as you said, the Pacers did have problems with injuries. The team roster missed 219 games due to injuries. So compare that to the 69 games missed by the Pacers in 2014. Big difference.
And that one's good, Ellis.
Wow, five straight buckets coming out of half. They are rolling.
Parker passes to Leonard. Dishes it to Duncan. Feeds it to Parker. To Duncan. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Leonard kicks to Parker. He dishes it to Aldridge. Paul George with the steal. Gives him the lead pass. And that one's good. 10 points for Hill.
It's amazing what they're doing on offense here. Perfect in this half.
And really, guys, the most telling part of the Pacers' injury troubles was this. Had to use 15 different starting lineups over the course of the season. Just hard to stay consistent and competitive when you are always replacing an injured player in the lineup.
That's good. Aldridge has got 18 points.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Ellis kicks to Allen. Hill. Back to Allen. Passes to Ellis. The pass to Hill. Ellis outside. On the high post. And again, it's Indiana converting. Spurs leading by 7. Parker outside. Kicks it to Duncan. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Parker's got his 8th assist in the game. Ellis outside. He kicks it to Hill.
Come get it.
Now the dish to Hill. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play. So Hill will go to the free throw line. Tim Duncan picks one up. Looking at who's out there now for the Spurs. Matt Bonner, he's checked in for Duncan. DL comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Rasul Butler's checked in for Kawhi Leonard. And it's Mills in for Manu Ginobili. Bonner dishes to Mills. Pass to DL. There's the feed to Mills. No one near him. Another one falls for San Antonio.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the finish.
Hill kicks to Hill. Stuckey. He feeds it to Whittington. Hill a screen on Dia. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Taking a look at Cleveland. And not a surprise, really, to see them sitting there in that number one spot in the conference. The excellent brand of basketball they've been putting on display lately has been terrific. And checking out Indiana, 9.5 games behind.
And right now for the Pacers, their season has been exactly the kind of misadventure their fans were afraid it might be.
Yeah, it's been ugly. I mean, we knew things were going to have to fall into perfect place for them to contend, but nothing did.
Timeout called, the Pacers. Last season, Clark, the Spurs kept on winning as usual. They passed the Lakers, in fact, for the best winning percentage all time for a franchise.
Well, some of that has to do with the struggles the Lakers had last season, but more of it is credit to the Spurs. Consistency and high-quality play has been who they are and have been for two decades.
Outside Hill. Pass to Hill. It's back to Hill. Shot clock at 6. The 3. That is good. Hill's got 5.
And with the Spurs and their winning percentage, it's right above 60. Not bad for a team that joined the NBA back in 1977.
Parker kicks to Diaw. Back to Parker. That's good. Parker's got 5 points now this quarter.
A lot of the Spurs' success, guys, with their winning percentage has come since the 90s. The way they are put together, who knows how high they can push that franchise winning percentage.
And the shot is good from Stuckey.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass, nice assist.
Dishes to Parker. Parker left side. Good. Parker's got 15 points.
I've really appreciated their activity in the post today. I mean, their movement down low has been great.
Oh, that's right on the money. They've generated a lot of easy opportunities on the inside.
Now Hill, 10 points for him. Trains it as the shot clock ticks down. Hill's got 9 points now in just the second half. Spurs leading by 9. And here's Mills. He's got 5. He passes it to Parker. Feeds it to Mills. With the shot. And it's good on the assist by Parker. Mills has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
Outside Hill. Outside Hill. He dishes it to Stuckey for 3. And Indiana, another 3.
That is his shot, guys. So you can't just give it to him. You've got to get up on him and get into his airspace there.
Parker against Hill. Parker passes to Diaw. Back to Parker. Just 5 to shoot. Tries to keep it alive. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pacers will take it.
Taking a look back over the last month, Kevin, let's see how Indiana stacked up. First in rebounding, 13th in steals. And they're in the top half of the league in blocks. That's pretty good. Not too bad.
And also, I love their work on the boards. I mean, they put multiple bodies in the paint. Truly a team effort, and that's why they're the best in the league.
Hill, no good.
They are really getting the work done inside with their rebound.
The defensive backboard has been controlled. They have not allowed a lot of second chances. It's been about one and done for the most part. And I'm not talking about leaving Collins.
Yeah, I know you're not. That's a bunch of good rebounding taking place there, boy.
Leonard dishes to Parker. The rebound by Turner.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
George against Diaw, and George kicks to Hill. Oh. Puts up a three, and that one's good. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. And we've watched three so far in this one. Spurs lead by five. And fourth
Spend your Christmas Day with the NBA. Anthony Davis and the New Orleans Pelicans go up against Dwayne Wade and the Miami Heat this Friday. Don't miss it.
And thanks for joining us again as the fourth quarter of play is set to get rolling. It's been a close battle to this point. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Spurs.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
Yeah, and the other thing that they've done well is they've really attacked the gaps of the defense with quick, decisive drives down the lane.
Parker and Danny Green are your one and your two. Kawhi Leonard is out there with LaMarcus Aldridge. And it's West in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the San Antonio five. And that one falls for LaMarcus Aldridge. Indiana didn't have a great record on the road last season. Only went, Clark, 15-26 on the year, and it crushed them down the stretch.
It really did, Kevin. I mean, the Pacers had a bumpy year with all of the injuries, particularly with George being out for most of the year. And his absence was most noted in those tough road games.
The drive by Hill takes it from 10. That one wide left.
They really depend on him to convert those chances. A lot of times, even with solid D draped on him, they expect him to make it.
And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
And for the Pacers, perhaps the biggest loss of the season for them was on the road. Couldn't get it done in Memphis on the final day of the season to try and get into the postseason.
Lavoy Allen's checked in for Ian Mahimi.
Well, here's a little factoid about the Pacers on the road last season, guys. They were much better shooting free throws on the road. The difference between their road and home free throw percentage was the largest positive mark in the league. That's kind of strange.
Hill kicks to Allen. Allen left side. Stuckey passes to Hill. With the putback. Great positioning on the putback. And it's 6 points for Allen.
And that's a really deft touch right there, guys.
And he just guided that ball back up and in. You know, Clark, just a fingertip touch on the ball.
Really, yeah. Well done.
And you know what? No need to catch it in a situation like that. He's got terrifically soft hands, and that finish doesn't allow the defense to react.
And Green gets it to go.
And really, the defense didn't do a lot to fight around that screen on that possession.
Allen with the screen for Stuckey. Pass to George. Back to Stuckey. Makes a big high bouncing, goes in.
It's as if the defenses have just given up.
Yeah, you know, the pace has only picked up the deeper we've gotten into this game, which is remarkable. It speaks to the endurance and stamina of these teams, and it's also been a lot of fun to watch.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Greg Popovich coaching his team during that last break. He said, we are this close to finishing them off, but the job is not done yet, and I don't want to see any let-up out there. We'll see how well his point got across, guys.
Thanks, Doris. Oh! And Parker, here we go. Good. Parker's got 12 points in just the second half.
And perhaps the best thing about him, Steve, is the way he takes charge down the stretch of close games. The higher the stakes, the better he plays.
And the pass to Ellis. Ellis, left side. Kicks it to Turner. Back to Ellis. On the line. And there are the Pacers with another bucket.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Here's Parker. Aldridge dishes to Green. 6 to shoot. Parker against Hill. Goes up on the wing. And again, it's Tony Parker. Parker's got 7 now in this quarter.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
Ellis outside. It's back to Hill. He kicks to George from outside the arc. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Hill's got 6 assists in the game.
Kevin, he's been a bright spot in what's otherwise been a little bit of a struggle for this team.
Outside, Green. Back to Parker. The dish now to Leonard. The Pacers pull it in.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Now here's Ellis. And there's the feed to Hill. Back to Ellis. A 3 ball. Good. And now just a 4-point Spurs lead.
You know, when he gets rolling, guys, he can be an absolute handful to have to deal with. And right now, he is rolling strong.
Back to Parker. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. Parker's got 16 points here in the second half.
It's just what the doctor ordered here. Boy, have they needed him here in the fourth.
Yes, they have. He's made all 4 of his shots this quarter, Greg. Definitely looking to be a dangerous guy.
Ellis, that's good.
And I hate to be critical, but it's as if there has been 0 effort given on the defensive end.
Well, you know you like to be critical at times, Greg. You know, you love a healthy debate and being a contrarian, but you're right. I mean, this has been more a product of bad defense or no defense as opposed to great offense.
And Parker, here we go. Pass to Duncan. Entered on the wing. Paul George with the steal. And a fast break now for the Pacers. George with the ball, and he gets it to go. 22 points for Monte Ellis.
Even with the D lurking, he made it look easy with the soft finger roll.
Parker kicks to Leonard. Aldridge defended by Allen. Outside, Green. Here's the 3. And a great assist by Aldridge as that one goes in. Green's got 6 in the quarter.
And they've got to talk to each other on D there. Miscommunication, and now he's able to make him pay.
Turner with a screen on Green. The drive by Ellis. A floater, and it's good on the way in. Ellis has got 24.
He has been fantastic this quarter, guys. It's just the kind of effort they need if they're going to continue to trim the lead.
Aldridge with it, and Allen picks him up defensively. Aldridge, the pass to Duncan. Back to Aldridge. He's against Allen. A jump hook, and it's San Antonio with another. Pacers trail by 5. Hill up top, covered by Parker. Hill up top. It's George on the wing. 6 on the shot clock. Allen outside. Ellis outside. They get it back. Tries again. And it's sent back by Aldridge. Leonard with the ball. Now Parker. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. The Pacers making a switch here. Hill's checked in. Pacers trail by 5. Ellis outside. Outside Hill. Kept alive by Indiana. He feeds it to George. Left side, George. Hill. Back to George. Just 5 on the clock. And the basket good. George has got 5 points now this quarter.
He has definitely shown up to play. He's done his part, really just trying to battle his team back into it.
Ginobili dishes to Leonard. 1:49 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Good! 26 points for Tony Parker. And the Pacers call time here. They're losing by 5. 1:46 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Hill. Ellis, left side. Good, the assist goes to Hill. Hill's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring him back.
Duncan with the screen for Parker. And that one's good. Parker's got 28 points for the game.
He is just tearing it up this quarter. That lead's not going anywhere while he's this high.
The drive by Ellis. Hill. We've got 1:13 left to play here in the fourth. Back to Ellis. Clock at 6. The 11-footer. Again, Indiana.
I think his team needs to get him the ball every chance they get. I mean, he's 7-for-8 now in the fourth quarter, guys.
Ginobili against Ellis. Ginobili kicks to Duncan. It's good! Indiana's gone 2-for-5 on 3-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And here's George. And it's Ellis penetrating. And there's the call on Ginobili. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the Bees.
Greg, no problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
George with the ball. Leonard picks him up. And here's Ellis from beyond the arc. Money! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Monte Ellis, one of the great scorers in the game, and his team is getting his best effort right now.
So it's San Antonio now. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. And they go to the intentional foul.
Yeah, you know what? Smart foul. You got to try and extend the game.
Sure. It's not over. The clock is as much a problem for them as the score is right now, so they've got to try to manage it.
And so both free throws are good. And it's a 4-point ball game.
2-possession game now, guys. Some very important free throws there.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. They trail by 4. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
You know, and not only do you want to draw up a score here, but it's got to be a quick one.
Yeah, it has to be quick. They've got to convert, and then there has to be an immediate foul.
Hill passes to Ellis. Ginobili with the steal. And there's the intentional foul. No choice but to stop the clock here. First free throw is good, and that puts them up by 5. Second one is good, being both at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
And he adds to their lead with some very solid free throws.
The 3 from Hill, hands the 3. Nine seconds left here in the fourth quarter. And an intentional foul there stops the clock. So the first one drops, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a five-point game.
No mistakes there. I think you can close the book on this one, guys. It's done.
And here's Ellis from beyond the arc. No good. And so it's San Antonio with the win. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but...